Hello, Marvel Hotline.
Hi, this is Jeff Parker for the Marvel Hotline. Today we're talking about Follow the Hulk's Red Hulk number one. This series goes back and fills in some mysterious gaps that you may have wondered about when you've seen little references and odd things Red Hulk has done or mentioned. You start to find out that he really doesn't do anything by accident. And there's quite a few people now involved, and he's working with Bruce Banner and Rick Jones, who's now known as A-Bomb. In this series, you're going to find out the creation of the A-Bomb. You're going to find out why Thundra was helping Red Hulk back in the Code Red storyline, and a bunch of other things that are pretty exciting. He's very good at drawing 900-pound guys who can knock buildings down. That's something I can safely say about Carlos. He really gets into drawing the big guys when Red Hulk and A-Bomb are going around mixing it up. He's clearly right in his element. It's a hats off to Carlos. Realize that a lot of what Red Hulk is doing is very similar to the way Bruce Banner Hulk first came into the Marvel Universe. He elicits the same sense of menace and threat. No one trusts him. And like everybody else, I hated him at first. Like, who's this guy I think he is calling himself the Hulk or whatever. And now, you know, that I've had a chance to present some of his side of the story, I'm starting to, it's hard not to empathize with him a little bit. It's like you realize that he's got his own plans. His goals may not be the worst goals in the world in some ways. So I strangely found myself rooting for him. This is Jeff Parker. You've been watching Marvel Hotline.
Thanks for calling. Check back next week for more Marvel Hotline.
Marvel, your universe.